There's always been a lot of talk in the rope and confined space circles about the use of a rigging plate and whether it constitutes a single critical point of failure, and actually whether we should be backing up a rigging plate either with a second rigging plate or a textile sling. From a team-based rope or confined space rescue perspective, does the legislation help? It depends. Depends which country you're in. Depends which legislation or code of practice you're looking at. So for this testing, we're going to leave aside the more complex issues of regulations or codes of practice and which are applicable to us. Following discussions with Helix and DMM in Llanberis, North Wales, we decided to conduct some testing on whether the use of a second rigging plate actually weakens other components in your system. DMM very kindly gave us the use of their test rig for the day, and I'd be lying if I didn't say I got a little bit excited about pulling carabiners and rigging plates apart. I know, I should get out more. We decided to test the following pieces of equipment. We used the large bat plate, great name. We used the following aluminium connectors. There was the Shadow D, the Shadow HMS, the Perfecto Oval, the Ultra O Oval, the Ultra D, and the Boa. We also tested the steel 12mm offset D. So we then connected a rigging plate by two connectors or carabiners to the test rig and basically pulled them apart. We set the connectors up basically with the gate down, so it replicated what you would do operationally. And it also had the added benefit of we used both ends of the carabiner that connected to the rigging plate. So the top carabiner or connector connected via the gate end, and the lower carabiner always connected to the rigging plate by the hinge end. We used the same single back plate for all the single pull tests, and we used the same two rigging plates, back plates, for all the doubled up tests. Each back plate is 10mm thick, and so that obviously gave us 20mm surface area for the double pulls. Once this was set up, we just pulled it to destruction. So let's look at some of the tests. We'll show a handful of tests here, but the full test results will be available to download at the end of this presentation.
there is an iPad to instrument.
So the results of our testing showed quite clearly that all connectors failed at or above their stated minimum breaking strength when used with a single rigging plate. However, when the same type of connectors were used on two back-to-back rigging plates, whether they were bolted together or loose, we saw an overall 5-10% reduction in overall strength of the connectors. This actually went up to about 23% reduction in strength when used with two rigging plates in one of the tests. And actually, some of the connectors failed below their stated minimum breaking strength on the two plates. So interestingly, which connector or carabiner broke varied whether we were using a single plate or a double plate. When we were using a single plate, it varied between the top carabiner or the bottom carabiner. It could be either one of them that broke. However, when we used two back-to-back rigging plates, it was always the lower connector, the lower carabiner that broke. Why is this? So the way we orientated the connectors or carabiners on the rigging plate, the lower connector always had its hinge end or the narrowest end of the carabiner running over the large surface area of two rigging plates, 20mm, which would have put more strain on the gate in that situation. Interestingly, in the D-shaped carabiners, those with the most acute angle at the hinge end, so those with a sharp angle, tended to lose the most strength. As you can see from the carabiners, the offset D has a much more acute angle than the shadow or the ultra D, which we believe has a bearing on how much strength is lost. Having said that, the steel D was ridiculously strong anyway, and way above any other part of your system probably. So at the end of the day, after pulling carabiners apart all day, we decided to try and break a rigging plate. So we put this back in the rig. We used the same single rigging plate we'd been using all day, and we used the same eyelets that we'd been using all day. We put steel bar through the eyelets and basically pulled. On the first pull, we took this up to 80, 85 kilonewtons, and nothing happened, nothing broke, no eyelets pulled through. So we brought this back down and then thought, okay, well, let's take it up a little bit further, put it back in the rig, same eyelets, same back plate, and pulled again, this time up to 90 kilonewtons, and still nothing broke. So to put this in context, the BCCTR worst case event is around 15 kilonewton load. So the rigging plate didn't fail at 90 kilonewtons. We did see some elongation of the eyelets when we took the plate up to 90 kilonewtons, but nothing broke and no eyelets pulled through. We actually bent the steel bar we were using to pull the back plate. We've got quite a nice bend in the bar. Talking with DMM, the most likely place for a rigging plate to fail, if you're going to fail one, would be pulling an eyelet out. However, it's fair to say every other part or every other component of your system would fail before you manage to pull an eyelet out of a 60 kilonewton plus rated rigging plate. There are actually a number of checks that rigging plates go through during the manufacturing process which would show up any damage or cracks in that plate. The hardening process, for instance, shows up very clearly if there's a crack or a problem with the plate. And actually, the anodizing process, which I initially thought had the potential to hide cracks or problems with the plate, I was actually reliably informed that it's quite the opposite. It actually highlights any cracks in the system during the anodizing process. So there are a number of checks there, which mean before you even get your plate, it's been thoroughly checked. So as long as you buy your rigging plate from a reputable manufacturer, these rigging plates are ridiculously strong. So are you inadvertently making your whole system or other components in the system weaker by using two back-to-back 10 millimeter rigging plates? From our testing, yes, it seems you are. It would be nice to do some further testing on this. However, I think the results were quite clear. What we would like to have done was use two thinner rigging plates, for instance. So a lot of manufacturers, small or extra small rigging plates, those with 3 to 4 eyelets, tend to be around 6-7 millimeters. So a little bit thinner than the medium or large back plates that most manufacturers offer. Would two small rigging plates, let's say adding up to 12 millimeter, act the same way as a single 10 mil? This is something we could test in future. However, it's fair to say that most of the time we tend to use a rigging plate to make the whole system neater and bring everything to a single focal point for ease of use. And small rigging plates would not give us enough space in this regard anyway. Would a sling backup survive in a worst case scenario which broke the plate, or much more likely the carabiners? Let's just say I was glad to be behind protective screens when there was bits of carabiner and connectors flying everywhere in the test rig. We were unable to test this scenario in controlled conditions, and in fact the only way you could do this would be to drop 100 kilonewton plus load onto a rigging plate. And to do this you would have to use steel bars instead of normal connectors or carabiners, otherwise your connectors or even rope are going to break first. So whether the secondary force is enough to break the sling as well is probably a moot point, as all other components in your system would break first. So do we need to back up a single rigging plate with an MBS of 60 kilonewtons plus, either with a second rigging plate or a textile sling? As a single piece of equipment with no moving parts that's easy to inspect, with very little room for user error short of forgetting to clip it all together, in that context, we believe a single rigging plate would be suitable to use as a single critical point in the system.